Blackheads, I am your host Manvi, and today I'm going to share my Sunday skincare routine. And I just had my breakfast. I made some cheese rolls and I put some pineapple into it and some cheese, and voila, you have your cheese rolls. Sunday is like that one pamper day when I like to pamper my skin and make some juice. That's how I like to start my day. So I have had my breakfast, I'm feeling good. Now I'm going to do my pamper skincare routine. It is different from my weekday skincare routine. On weekends, I like to take care of my skin, clean all of that gunk out from my face, and also take care of my blackheads and whiteheads. I have a lot of those. So initially what I used to do some facials. I tried facials, but then when I came back home, it broke me out for a whole week and I was scared. Okay, after that I don't go for facials. Okay, I take care of my skin on my own. So I tried masking. Okay, masking is good, I love that. But then I started using chemical peels, and oh my god, I have not looked back. Okay, like it takes care of my blackheads for almost a week. So I have cleaned my face. Make sure that you have cleaned your face from a gentle cleanser. That's the first step of every skincare routine. And I've been doing this skincare routine for almost like 1.5 years, and I cannot believe that I have not shared it with you. All right, so first step of any skincare routine is cleaning your face, and I've cleaned my face using the simple kind of skin face wash. Okay, now we are going to apply the chemical peel and make sure that your face is dry. And I'm using the Dr. Sheth chemical peel. This is their basic brightening extra gentle daily peel, but do not use it daily, use it only once a week. Okay, so I'm going to apply it on my skin, and this is literally the star of the show. It suits every skin type, it's very gentle on the skin, and I leave it on my skin for almost 10 to 15 minutes. I feel 15 minutes is perfect, not too long, not too short. So I'm going to apply it on my skin. Pump of this one is not great, so I'm just going to pump it out on my hand and then apply it on my skin. You will feel a little bit tingly on the skin. That means it's working. Make sure it's not feeling like burning. If it feels like burning, then you have to wash it off. Do a patch test before using this peel or any skincare. So I like to leave it on for at least 15 minutes on my skin, and meanwhile I like to catch up on my K-dramas. So I'm currently watching True Beauty, and I'm also watching Run On, and I could relate it to more because it's about the independent artists like athletes, a translator, painter, who are doing things on their own, and how different their lives are from a regular 9-to-5 job. People, you need a lot of self-motivation, especially when you are doing things on your own or you are a sports athlete. You need a lot of self-motivation. I'm also like thinking of changing my room, my bedroom. Like, this is my studio room where I like to film my videos, and it's more royal and professional kind of setup. But in my bedroom, I want to feel cozy, and I want to make it more relaxed, like more bohemian theme kind of, you know. I'm finally feeling inspired, and I do have a design in my mind, so I am working on that currently. And of course I will reveal my bedroom, because I am changing my bedroom mainly because I also want to film some relaxed and chatty videos there. Like, sometimes I feel so inspired and I have something on my mind and I just want to make video at that time only. So it would be great to turn on my camera and just film. And of course my aesthetic should be on point, so that's why I'm, you know, redecorating my bedroom. My bedroom is fine right now, but I feel like I'm ready to take my bedroom to whole another level, like add more chill and bohemian vibes, like how I changed my studio room. So that's what I've been working on. And what else? Like, what do you do on Sundays? Let me know in the comments down below. I would love to know. I actually like to pamper myself. I cook something for myself, something yummy. I feel like 15 minutes are over. I should wash my face. And if you're new to chemical peels, it's basically to remove the dead skin cells from your skin. And if you are feeling that your skin is looking dull, this will give you that instant glow. You will see a huge difference from before and after using a chemical peel. And it's also really amazing for blackheads, for whiteheads, for hyperpigmentation, and it dissolves that bond which is holding the dead skin cells. That's why you get that glowy and beautiful skin after using a chemical peel. So now I'm going to wash my face and I will be back. Alrighty kitties, I am back, and do you see the glow on my skin? Like, it's real, before and after. So my skin is clean. I just washed it from plain water, and now I'm going to do the skincare. And after applying your chemical peel, which has glycol glycolic acid, you need to make sure that you do not apply glycolic acid toner after that, okay? Now, in the daytime, I like to use my Claire's Vitamin C Serum, but today I will not use it because after chemical peel, you want to use something healing, something soothing on the skin. That's why I recommend ingredients like your hyaluronic acid, cica, ceramides, peptides, all of those good ingredients which are also very soothing on the skin and will calm your skin down. So I would like to give you some examples of the serum that you can use after a chemical peel. Like you can use the ordinary hyaluronic acid serum. You can also use the Estee Lauder ANR Advanced Night Repair Serum. You can also use the Dr. Sheth Cica and Ceramide Serum. Centella Green Level Buffet Serum by Purito. And if you heard children screaming, that's because I have them in my basement. No, it's my neighbor's kids and they are hella noisy, okay? Today, I'm going to use the Estee Lauder Serum because it also has hyaluronic acid into it and it's very soothing on the skin and healing. So I'm going to apply this and it's almost my night skincare routine time. And you know that in my night skincare routine, I use the Estee Lauder Serum. So this serum is gentle, soothing and healing on the skin. And that's why I love to use it after my chemical peel. Now, I forgot the toner. I love to use the Karma Ayurveda toner, hydrating toner after your peels, but I forgot it, so you can use it before the serum. It completely skipped my mind. Chemical peels can make your skin dry. That's why I am applying all the hydrating things. That's why I recommend the Karma Ayurveda rose water toner, because it's always better to use extra layers of hydration. But no worries, I have used my serum and now it's time for the hydrating moisturizer. For moisturizer, I'm going to use the Neutrogena Hydro Boost moisturizer, and I've been loving this moisturizer from summers to winters. Like, it's so lightweight and has a gel consistency, but it also moisturizes my skin in winters as well. And we are done. I have taken care of my skin after using a chemical peel, and make sure that you do not use a glycolic acid based toner because you don't want to over exfoliate your skin, okay? That's also a thing. But use more hydrating and soothing ingredients, and also those ingredients which boost the collagen production, like your ceramides and peptides, your cica and ceramides, which is very healing on the skin, and your hyaluronic acid which attracts the water molecules from environment to your skin. Okay, sorry for my phone. And we are done. I also use the lip scrub, but I could not find my lip scrub. I use the Juicy Chemistry lip scrub, but I could not find it. So we are going to skip the lip care part today because I just could not find my lip scrub. But yeah, I think that's all for my Sunday skincare routine. I hope you got some extra pointers from this video and extra information. And I will be doing my weekly skincare routine very, very soon. So you will get a whole wide picture of my skincare routine. I think that would be more helpful and insightful. So wish me luck, because I have to film for a week my skincare routine. So that's going to be a little tedious, but I will do it for you. You can also layer a cream-based moisturizer if you feel that your skin is a little bit dry, especially in winters. So I like to use the Innisfree Green Tea Seed Moisturizer. It's indeed cream-based, but it melts into my skin like butter. It's very nourishing on the skin. My skin does not like thick cream-based moisturizer, but I think the Innisfree Green Tea Moisturizer is an exception. Like, love it. Also, if you're going outside, make sure that you use a sunscreen to protect your skin from UV rays, but I'm not going outside, so that's why I'm not using any sunscreen. So I think that's all for today's video, and I will see you soon. I hope you enjoyed my Sunday vlog, Sunday skincare, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.